Hi, creators. Today we're going to make something a little different. We're going to make some space and planets into a 3D scene in DaVinci Resolve 15 using Fusion. These are the types of images that we're gonna create, and it's very easy to make these 3D scenes in DaVinci Resolve. So sit back and enjoy this video. Here we go. Okay, so first we're gonna need to get some images that we're gonna use for textures on our 3D objects. And a great place to get those is NASA. So I will give you the link for this site on the description of this video. And so we're gonna just grab a couple of different images to start. We will obviously get the Earth, and we're gonna download this JPEG here. I'm gonna also get Jupiter. I'm going to grab actually Mars. And we're also going to take Venus as well. So we can go to our file. You'll have to unzip all these files first. I'm going to put them in a different folder so we can get to them a little faster. Next thing we want to do is go into the NASA image and video library, and we want to find a background that will be suitable for our scene. And so I found this Starfield in the constellation Cepheus, and I'm going to go ahead and just download that. The original size, as big as we can get. Right click on that one, and we will save that. Okay, now that we have all of our images saved, we're gonna want to get into Resolve, and we're gonna start our project. And so we're first going to just set up a Fusion composition. And so go to Generators down here and go to Fusion Composition, drag that in the timeline. And I wanna set this clip for about 15 seconds. So I'm gonna click on just an open space on the timeline. Type in 15:00, and it will set my position 15. I'm going to drag my timeline out to that 15 point and select the composition and go into Fusion. We now just have a blank flow area, and so we're going to start setting up our scene. So we're going to need some objects to get this set up. So we will start with a 3D shape, and we're going to make this a sphere. We're also going to go ahead and get our 3D merge. Let me set this to snap to grid so I can make this look a little bit better for you. I'm going to go ahead and get my camera, connect that one in, and let's get a image plane, connect that in as well into our 3D merge. And I also need something to place on our shape. So I'm going to start applying a texture to this. And so let's just go ahead and drag all of our media in that we downloaded. Just drag it all onto your flow area. Okay, and I forgot it made all these merge. We'll delete those. Okay, so let's get our organized media here in place by renaming everything. So if you drag the actual nodes up to the window, you'll see what's in the nodes. So this one is our star field. I'm gonna select that node and press F2 to rename it. I'm gonna call these Starfield. And I'll just do each of these. So now that we have all of our media renamed, we're gonna start putting together our 3D scene. And so I have my merge 3D still up in this view. And I'll drag my shape up to this view. And so we can just see it's a colorless sphere kind of out there in space. And so let's go ahead and get our star field set up. So we want to go from the out of the star field into this image plane. And you can see it's kind of hidden back here. Let's move our camera. I'll slide that out a little bit. And back here, I want to make this image plane quite a bit bigger. So we're going to go to the Transform tab on the actual image plane node. I'm going to bump this up. I Let's go up to 6. That should be big enough. Okay, so right now my planet is not connected to the scene, so I'm going to go ahead and add that to the Merge 3D. We also want to add a Render 3D. And so we want to go from the Merge 3D out to the Render 3D. I'll go ahead and connect my media out so we can have that all ready to go. I'm going to drag my Render 3D scene here so we can see we're really close to the planet. So I'm going to pull this back. And that's looking a little bit better. And if we want to move the view of this camera, we have the option to go to, say we're going to go to the left view, and I can hold down the control button and turn the wheel, and that'll slide it out. And so let's take a look and see where that shape is. Actually, the image plane. It's right in the center of that planet. I want to pull it back just to the back edge of the actual, I'm sorry, wrong way, to the back edge of the actual planet. And put this view back in perspective view. And so that looks pretty good. I'm going to move the camera back just a little bit more. Now I know in a real space scene, the stars are really far from the Earth. So we're going to have, we could move this way back and in the Z direction. And we can make it scale it up so it's huge, more like realistic space. But I want to use some effects later on in the scene, so I just want to have this background pretty close to the actual volume space of our planet. And so we have this piped in here. We can just go ahead and connect this Earth, and we do have a pretty decent looking scene, but I'm going to show you some issues with that here in a second. And so, you know, this looks kind of cartoonish. It looks, you know, not very realistic. So we want to actually apply some lighting to this scene so we can have some more natural appearance. And so if we go ahead and click on the Merge 3D, press Shift and Space, and we're going to type in light. I want to put a spotlight into the scene. And I want to go to the Render 3D and enable lighting and go ahead and turn on our shadows. And so our spotlight is centered really on the planet, and you can see it's right there, and this is pretty bright. I'm going to move it to the side a bit, and I'm going to rotate it kind of just so it's hitting the edge of the Earth there. Move it some more. Okay, that's looking pretty good location. It doesn't look good. And we're going to have some settings that we want to change as I select the light. I'm going to turn the intensity way up to 75. And wow, that, you know, that doesn't look very, very good. But what we want to do is turn the decay type down to quadratic. And so that's going to soften the light, start to soften the light quite a bit. And so I want to now bump up this decay rate. So I'm going to type in 9. And these sliders have edges, but it just gives a range. So if you type in higher numbers, it gives you a new range. So you can type really kind of anything you want. Okay, so, and I want to move the angle of this light out to about a 10. And so that's still looking terrible. And the reason is because we basically just pulled our color right into and placed it on top of the actual sphere. So we need to do something a little different. I'm going to break this connection, and I want to apply a material. And there's two ways to get to it. You can search for it, or you can right click in the flow area and go to add tool 3D. And these are the material options. And basically there is a blend is kind of the main one that's used quite a bit. And you know, it's supposed to be the all purpose actual material, but I'm going to go ahead and add that one, and I'm going to add the Cook Torrents. The Fong and the Ward are actually two other pretty good ones that have some good uses. Cook Torrents is supposed to be set up more for shinier materials like plastics and metals, and Blend is supposed to be more of an all-purpose, but I'm going to show you that actually Cook Torrents works a lot better in this case. So let's add the Blend, and we will add, I'm going to add it the other way, Cook Torrents. Add that one. And so I'm just going to give you a look at both of those. So if we pull in, say, the blend, now remember what this looks like. I'm going to now bring it into the diffuse color material, into the blend, and then we'll go out to the shape, and that needs to go into the material input on the shape. That looks pretty much the same, but now if I break those, I will put this into the actual, I want to go to the same thing, diffuse color, and then out to the shape. Now look at that. So the Cook Torrents actually has an extra node to apply those speculars and the shininess. So on default, if you enter a color map and it doesn't give you any shininess whatsoever, and that can be very useful if you have a material that you want to apply. In this case, the earth, I think, you know, certainly the water has reflectiveness, but in this case, I don't want to add that reflectiveness to the scene. So the Cook Torrents works really well. I'm going to go ahead and delete the blend out. This is looking okay, but we have a problem. So our background now is showing kind of this this haze around it. And so in the lighting setting, if we go back to the regular settings and click on this lighting setting, let's just turn off the affected by lights. So now that's starting to look really good. I'm pretty happy about that. We have that nice, soft, natural edge there of the planet. And if we go into the actual shape and go to the transform tool, rotating this on the y-axis, we can begin to think about animating this planet, which is really nice. So I want to add one more thing into the scene, and I'm going to break this connection. So I'm going to select the 3D merge, and I'm going to press shift spacebar, type in fog, and select the 3D fog. And so now we have an additional material in there. And I want to pull this render in again. Okay, so if we turn this fog off, you can see the difference there. It's just a little bit subtle. And right now I have it set on linear and I have the full fog distance. That's a little bit too much. So I'm actually going to go to exponential, and I want to just turn down the density and get the look that I want. So in space, we don't have a clear, there's no air in space, obviously, but there are particles because there's space debris from collisions of planets and things like that. So we don't ever get a perfectly clear median of space. There's always a little bit of particles in there. So I think this fog gives it a nice appearance to look a little bit more natural. And so the other thing that you get, if we have a pure black background and we don't get this kind of this edge, see this black edge here? So that's kind of nice. So there is some illumination behind it. It gives that appearance if we have that fog, because the fog has a little bit of depth. And so, but I kept it pretty close because let me show you this. If we take this image plane and let me go to the view here. If we take this image plane and we move it way back, like we talked about, and then scale that up, I'm going to make that, let's say, 25. I'll even move it back a little bit more. Okay. So if we have that far back, then our fog really starts to affect our background. We could probably get it to look a little bit better if we try to lower that fog down. But to me, it just looks a little bit grainy. You can't quite get the look that you want. So I like putting that background right behind the planet. I'm going to undo those, put that back into space, the space that we want, no pun intended. And I'll go back to our perspective camera view here. And so this is kind of what I was looking for. So now we can just go through here and break these and add the different planets. And that one doesn't look quite as good. We can make some adjustments though to make it look better. Mars. Cool. That looks pretty good. And then Venus. That's a really simple way to set up planets in outer space. So we'll go ahead and put the earth back on there, and I'll animate this real quick and get you some output. So if we go down to the timeline zero point, this timeline goes up to 359. And so I'm going to start with 60 as my rotation. I need to right click on this and select animate. And then I'm going to go to 360 or 359. And I'm going to pick 250. And so I don't want to rotate too fast because it's a planet. It goes fast, but not that fast. So, okay, we can now go back to the edit window and we can render this out. So we'll go ahead and do that and you can take a look at the results. Thanks for watching. Hopefully this tutorial on how to take the primitive shapes in Resolve and apply different textures to them can make a big difference in your scene, and you can quickly get object like planets into your scene, which is amazing. And you can apply different effects to them and make them look really fantastic. So thanks a lot for watching, and please subscribe to my channel if you really like some of these things that you're seeing, so I can be encouraged to put together some more tutorials for you. So hopefully you can learn some things in DaVinci Resolve and in Fusion within DaVinci Resolve, if that makes sense. So thanks again for watching. Take care.